G'day. Today taking a look at the Morakniv Companion Heavy Duty. I've had this knife now for 2.5, 3 years, maybe a little bit more. Looking at it on the outside, it looks like it's barely been used. But believe me, it has. Now, the last time I used this was about 9 months ago. And all I did when I finished with it, with the intention of leaving it to see how it went, I just put it in the sheath and left it up until yesterday. And all I did yesterday was just give the blade a wipe down. You see, I've been cutting different wood. I've been battening with it. It's got a good workout. So let's have a look at the actual blade first, so you know what I mean, because you're going to see this as soon as I take it out of the sheath. So we'll do it now. Now, after, like I said, about 9 months, and just a quick wipe down, that's the condition of the blade. You probably see all the pitting in it, or the very little amount of pitting, put it that way. And a lot of knives after 9 months and a quick wipe down would be in a lot worse condition than what this is. So, answer a question from the beginning: is the blade any good? The steel that it's made out of any good? How long will it last? And that's a pretty good idea. Like I said, I've been using it for 2.5, 3 years. I've battened some hardwood. I've cut softwood with it. I've prepped wood. I've cut paracord. I've cut different ropes with it. And that's what the blade looks like after all that. Now, the rundown of this. Let's get my little notepad. The blade length from the tip here to the end here. Not the top, but from the tip to the full length of the blade at the longest point is 104 millimeters. The total length from the tip of the blade to this point here on the handle, they say is 223, but give a couple of, this one measures at 226. So it's 3 millimeters longer than they say, which is nothing really. The thickness of the blade, the normal ones are 2 or 2.5, I think they are, in thickness. With the heavy duty, we've got 3.2 millimeter, that is, blade. The blade is a carbon steel and it comes sharp when you buy it out of the box with a lovely scandi grind on it. Now, I like the scandi grind because I find it a lot easier to keep it sharp when I'm out in the bush. You just laying it flat and sharpen it so easy. Not like with the other cut types, you've got to get it at just that angle to find that sweet spot. Wherever it is, it lays flat with the actual flat of the blade, that is, as it goes down in the scandi grind, not with the flat of the blade at the top here. It just makes it so much easier to keep sharp. The actual sheath is a polypropylene. As you can see, that's lasted quite well. It's been dropped, it's been taken through the bush, it's been strapped on the back of the pack, and yeah, it's still in pretty good order. Total weight of the whole thing, they say, is 4.8 ounces. Now, I'm taking their word for that because I haven't weighed it. And it's actually made in Sweden. Now, That's all the specs on it. We've got a handle, which I think we've got the polypropylene section here with a rubber coating over it, and it gives a really, really nice grip. I haven't had it fall out my hand or slip. I've still got all my fingers there, a few scars, but they're from different things. That's a chainsaw one, and I've got, you know, on this hand, I've got another one with a knife cut straight through the finger, and I had to stitch that all back up, the tendon, but not this one. It stayed really firm in my hand, comfortable and nice. Now the spine of it hasn't got a sharp 90 degree spine. So when it comes out of the box and striking a ferro rod, you're not going to get a spark out of it. What I have done with this one is when I've been sharpening it, I've just turned it over and I've been rubbing it on the actual sharpening stone I've got, and I've put myself a nice little edge here, so now I can use it for striking a ferro rod. But out of the box when you buy it, you can feel the blade, where am I, just here, where it's still got a bit of a round to it. You're not going to get a strike from there, but on this side I could feel the nice sharp 90 degree. So if you are going to be wanting to use this with a ferro rod, you are going to have to file the back down to give you a nice 90 degree back on it to use the ferro rod. Battening with this, I've battened one of the hardest woods here in Australia, which is the Jarrah, and I've left probably just short of an inch of the tip. So we're looking at pieces of Jarrah, what's about three and a half inches, and it's gone through it and it hasn't snapped yet. So I'm hoping it doesn't. The blade is not a full tang. I think it comes about 3/4 of the way. And as you can see, it's still in decent condition. No bend, no twisting, no snapping. Still got a nice sharp point on it. I did a little video about a sharpening stone using this, and somebody says he hasn't sharpened the tip. Well, the tip has stayed very sharp, and it's very rare that I actually have to touch that up. Most of the cutting is done with this section here, so that it makes it even easier when you're sharpening it on a sharpening stone. Now, I like this. It's cheap. I think it's about $30 Australian here. I bought two. One to use and abuse, and one for a second one of my packs, so it's always there just in case I forget to pick one up when I grab the other pack. So what's that, that's $60 Australian, that's, what's that about, I don't know, in American or what, in English pounds. I'm going to have a look at it now, but for the value, that is bloody good price. It's cheap but good quality blade, nice knife. And looking at that, as long as I keep looking after this from that this point onwards, that'll last me 25-30 years. I might knacker it up when doing the battening, but up to now there's no signs of it being damaged or possibility of getting damaged with the way I use it. Now, not light-handed with it, like I said, I've battened and I've used it on some really hard wood here. And there, there's not much more we can say about that, apart from it's done the job, it's well worth the money, and I like it. So I hope you've enjoyed the video, and if you have, please go down below and click on the subscribe button. Click on the notification bell next to it and select all, so you can be notified of all future videos, and hit the thumbs up button, the like button. And if you are already a subscriber, again, I thank you very much.